All right, I gotta stand up. Like, I need this mic for the function. All right, so my name is Shen'naque Sean Butler. I am a Bronx health advocate. I started a program called Team Healthy Heart, which basically trains K-5 elementary students on how to navigate the food apartheid that's happening here in the Bronx. I know you guys have heard them say that the Bronx is number 62 when it comes to health. You want to be number one. We're last out of 62 counties. It's usually dead last. So within that, there's a lot of social determinants of health work that needs to be done. And for those of you who do not know what the social determinants of health work means, it's just the structural racism. All right, so my family is from the Black Belt of the country, which is Georgia and Alabama, and all the places that all the civil rights stuff started taking place in. And that is because of structural racism. So the Civil Rights Law, Voting Rights Act, all this stuff protects us, right? In theory. With that being said, when it comes to the socioeconomics of health, there's structural racism that turned the Bronx into one of the worst health outcomes in the world. I mean, not in the world, but in the country. All right, so I want to just briefly go into that. How many of you guys remember when the Bronx was burning? Okay, all right, so that gives me a chance to fill it in. All right, so the Bronx was once a thriving community, same way as Compton. Compton was once a thriving community. Then something called redlining happened. And what redlining does, it takes all of the economic opportunities and resources out of one place and places it into another. Well, when this happened in the Bronx, landlords began to burn their buildings down because they could not get tenants to pay money because there was no money to be made. So they started burning their buildings down for insurance. The term the Bronx's burning became a very popular term because of the World Series was happening one year, I think it was 1977, and the announcers were saying, oh my gosh, the Bronx is burning. Did you see buildings burning down as the World Series was happening here in the Bronx? So that's what the social economics of health is about. It's about the removing of resources that creates ghettos, or they are, whatever you term you want to use for that. But it creates poverty, basically. And within that, there are mechanisms that we can use, and I believe that the New York Health Act is one of the tools that we can use to get rid of the structural racism that is happening here in the Bronx. I always use this analogy. There are two Park Avenues in New York. You've got Park Avenue in the Bronx, and you have Park Avenue in Manhattan, and they both have two totally different health outcomes, and that's because of how things are structured within the system that ensures that this area does not get the resources that it needs in order to push the needle forward and get us out of 62nd place when it comes to health. So that's just, I'm briefly just gonna touch base on that, because I know that we have a lot more stuff to cover. And like Helen and Catherine and Leonard, you know, we'll all be here just to answer some of your questions. But social economics, it plays a major part when it comes to health. And I think oftentimes it's overlooked and people get blamed for their situation that was by design. There's no guesswork that comes with how could you have two Park Avenues in the same city with two totally different health outcomes. Why not? It's by design. And for any further information on that, the Department of Health has an excellent campaign called Take Care of New York 2020, where they actually talk more about structural racism, and they have a lot of data that you can access via online, and they also have an imprint of just the health outcomes and why. All right, so the why is very important because lots of the time people don't know why things are happening, and once you know why, you're able to focus on a way to fix it. So I'm just gonna briefly talk. Okay. This is Oh, all right. So I'll just read something that Helen just sent us. Poor people have no substandard health care, resulting in the health outcomes that in Costa Rica that are in worse than Costa Rica and in Cuba. Wow. Okay. In New York, black women are 3-4 times more likely to die in childbirth than white women. In New York City, the number jumps by 12 times more likely to die. 55% of uninsured New Yorkers are people of color. All right, so this is speaking directly to us. And as I say, when you have a system that is set up to keep the wealth up here for a certain privileged group, and then all the poverty and failure of economics in one particular group, that is not something that is by coincidence. It's definitely by design, and I believe New York Health Act can level the playing field when it comes to that by taking just the profit out of it and just putting the health in more in our hands as a community. If you need an MRI, your insurance company should not tell you no, we will only pay for a CAT scan if you need an MRI. You know, and the New York Health Act will definitely eliminate